So this week, we're going to start working on our final project, which deals with web applications. And we are going to be using Django as our framework. So I felt that the best way to approach this was to cover each chapter separately, because there's an awful lot of information in each chapter. So we're going to start with part one, which is basically setting up your environment, getting your app set up correctly, adding models, doing migrations to create the database itself, and doing some easier retrieval screens. No styling yet. We are basically going to get the application up and functioning, and we will add in styling last. It's the bells and whistles. So for styling, we are going to be using Bootstrap. So this week, a lot of what you are going to be doing is making sure that you know how to set up the app correctly into Django. It does require a certain amount of attention to detail because there are conventions in the Django that you must follow in order for your app to work. And so I basically created a whole lot of, I have to fix this link. I created a whole lot of videos. And what I did was I included the videos for each section in the hands-on. So as we go through the hands-on sections, I pretty much explain what the concepts are and how to do it at the same time. So creating the virtual environment, installing Django, the how-to is in the video, and also the why. So you'll get both the demonstration and the explanation in each of the hands-on. And there are 14 of them. So there are a lot. This setting this up correctly is a little bit tricky. As long as you follow the conventions, you should be okay. And as if you watch the videos, you will be okay, because I am following the conventions and I point out areas where you could run into trouble. So each of the hands-on has videos for you to watch. When you're completely done, we are not deploying the app for several weeks. So what you need to turn in are screenshots, just so that I can see that you know, you're on track and that you completed it. So you're going to do a learning log, which is in the chapter, and then the try it yourselves, have you do a pizzeria. I'm having you do both of these so you can get the process down. And then next week, we will be covering how to do the CRUD, all the updates, the update templates. And then we will also learn a little bit about creating user accounts. And next week, I will also give you the requirements for the last project of the semester. I'm not giving them to you this week because I want you to focus on learning the conventions and how to, you know, put your app together correctly. For those of you that like to copy and paste, this is not something that you can copy and paste. You cannot copy your learning log folder and make a pizzeria folder out of it. It will not work. You are going to have to kind of start from scratch and, you know, go through the process of creating the app. To help you guys with the try it yourselves, you will notice that I summarized the steps. Okay, so these are all of the steps that you have to follow through to accomplish that particular hands-on. And if you have typos or misspellings, Or if you try to copy paste something, you will probably end up with an error. You want to make sure you do everything from scratch. If you have errors, because the app is not deployed, it's going to be really hard for me to help you unless you meet with me in Zoom. So look at the office hours for this week. Attend existing office hours, or you can throw me an email, and if I am available, I will be able to meet with you. When I'm not teaching, I do have quite a few meetings that I have to attend. And so I'm not always readily available. I'm usually available in the evenings, however. So if you do have problems, usually evenings are when it's easiest to get a hold of me. I did include links to additional resources. And I think once you guys get the framework down, how to work with it, it is pretty powerful and you can quickly build web apps with it. So it's just a matter of learning it. So if you run into problems or have questions, let me know. And I am happy to meet with you in Zoom whenever I am not teaching or not in meetings. So hopefully you'll have a great week, and let me know if you run into problems.